So, what are the latest speculations around Elon Musk purchasing Dogecoin, Elon Musk purchasing Bitcoin? People are trying to find a connection between those purchases. And in this video, guys, we're going to see what are the latest speculations.
Let's take a look at Bitcoin, because that's at 51,000 bucks, and bring in Douglas Borthwick, our crypto guy of this Wednesday morning. I want to know about Musk. I don't want to talk about Bitcoin. I want to talk Dogecoin. He says, Musk says, buy it. And the thing goes to 8 cents a coin. Then he says, sell it, and it comes down to 5 cents a coin. What's going on here? Some people have been left holding the bag, the little guy. Do you approve of that? I mean, you're in the middle of this crypto market. Do you approve of this guy? I'm not going to call it manipulation, but I'm going to call it gross influence. What do you say about it?
I think you're right. There is gross influence here, but have you ever played three card Monty?
Yes.
What you don't want is when you're buying something like Bitcoin, you don't want everyone to know you're buying. And so what you do is you put everyone's attention on Dogecoin. Doge is a joke. Everyone's looking at Doge, making jokes about Doge. Meanwhile, he's buying $1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin. And if he'd come out talking about Bitcoin, Bitcoin would have gone up even more than it has already. So I think he's playing three card Monty. But I do believe it is irresponsible. There's folks getting into Dogecoin. It's not a serious coin. It's not listed on all exchanges. INEX, my company, won't list Dogecoin because we do see it as being a bit of a joke. And it has no practical benefits whatsoever. Now, maybe he's amassing it so he can have a currency for Mars. But then that's speculation. The reality is, I don't think it's Elon that has this, but I do think he's playing three card Monty.
Which other cryptos do you list on your exchange which you think are legitimate, whereas Dogecoin you think is a joke?
Well, look, Bitcoin is the most legitimate.
Yep.
And then you've got Ethereum, which is gas, covering a lot of different projects that are happening in the market right now. There's obviously Charlie Lee's Litecoin. I think that's great. There's ZEC, USDC stablecoins. I think that stablecoins are going to end up being the sort of currency of choice for quite some time in the US. You can own USDC right now and you can earn something like 10% on it. And yet if you own US dollars in your bank account, you own next to nothing.
Okay.
So cryptocurrencies are certainly offering a lot.
Is this an alternative to gold? Is this the player against inflation, Bitcoin, as opposed to gold?
It's absolutely a play against inflation, and it's mobile. Try carrying around $1 billion worth of gold in your pocket, but you can do that with Bitcoin. So that's one thing. It's also divisible. You don't have to have a big nugget in your hand. You can get slivers of Bitcoin. You don't have to buy just one Bitcoin. You can get little pieces of it. But at the same time, it's rallying hard because, as you said earlier in your program, where are gas prices compared to the start of the year? Up, what, 70 cents? Well, either gas prices are going up or the dollar's going down. And people are buying Bitcoin, and in Bitcoin terms...
Okay, friends. What the guy's trying to point out is that if Elon Musk has the intention to buy Bitcoin, he wants to buy Bitcoin cheap. He doesn't want to pay a high price for the Bitcoin. He doesn't want to buy the top. We remember Elon Musk had on his bio on Twitter the Bitcoin emoji, right, for a while. Then he removed this emoji and then he tweeted a couple of times for Dogecoin. At that time, the price of Bitcoin was around $34,000-$36,000. Soon after, they purchased and they announced that they bought $1.5 billion of Bitcoin. There are speculations that the price of acquiring the Bitcoin was around $35,000-$36,000. Soon after, the price hit $49,000 after the purchase of Bitcoin. So, if we assume that they have intentions to buy Bitcoin, it kind of makes sense for Elon to not talk about Bitcoin and focus on something else. It's a Dogecoin, but this is again just a speculations. Again, Elon Musk purchased Dogecoin for his kid, right? Nobody knows how much he purchased, but the general investment in Bitcoin was not purchased from Elon Musk. The general investment in Bitcoin was purchased from Tesla, and Tesla has board of directors. It's not just Elon Musk making decisions by his own. So I think what they're trying to point out maybe has some potential truth, but I still think that Elon Musk won't act on the shade side, won't act as a potential trying to boost or reduce a price of certain assets.